Hey guys, it's me again, Ron Williams. Welcome back to the Ron Williams YouTube channel. Natural Mr. World, Mr. Universe, Mr. Olympia, and also Natural Bodybuilder of the Decade. Natural Bodybuilder of the Decade, somebody said, who made you Natural Bodybuilder of the Decade? Well, it was actually an award I received. So I didn't crown myself Natural Bodybuilder of the Decade. That would be so funny if I did that. I would be embarrassed to even say that. But I wanted to talk to you. This is more of a heart-to-heart today. I want to talk to you a little bit about releasing growth hormone. You know, everybody's a professional today. Everybody, I mean, because the internet is just so broad and so much information is on the internet for us to look at and to listen to. And one of the things that people have gravitated towards is that releasing natural growth hormone, they've got studies that says it can't be done through exercise. But I want you to know something. When you put together a study, you gather a group of people. You gather a group of 100 people and 50, you take this direction, and 50, you take this direction. And what they've actually done is they've grabbed a group of 100 people, test studies, and they've had them go through lifting weights, squats, deadlifts, and compound movements, and several other exercises, bench press, you name it, and then they test them when they start, and then they test them at the end to see if they've increased, well, or if they get any stronger. And what they've said in the studies is they've averaged about 4% increase. To me, 4% is tremendous. And they come to the conclusion that there's no release of natural human growth hormone. Well, I want to say this. When it is a test study, it's only for that study. But when you have an athlete with the mentality of an athlete, with the mentality of a champion, the lifting is much different. Because that person, when they get under that 500, 600, 700 pounds of weight, they're giving it everything they have, and it hurts, it's a struggle, and it means everything to them. And so they're more apt to do it and give their all, because it's not a test study. This is real life. This is where the rubber meets the road. They're going to get on stage and they're going to be judged, and they want to be the best. In a test study situation, you don't have that same mentality, nor do you have the mentality of an athlete that desires with everything that's in him to be number one. With me personally, when I was training for competition, I would actually taste human growth hormone in the back of my throat as I was lifting. I would go down and then I'd come up with a squat, and most people would think that's the last rep he's got. And I would go down again and again and again. You know why? Because I've got to grow. I've got to get those legs to grow. I've got to get the total body to grow. And it absolutely released human growth hormone. I've done it with other clients that I've had. I've watched it happen. But then we come out with these new studies where you have college students or whatever type of people that they gather in these studies, and they don't give 100%. Some of them don't even know what 100% is. They do what they think they're capable of doing because they don't have the same mentality as a competitive athlete. Now, you get some competitive athletes in those studies, and I guarantee you that the conclusion, that the results will be absolutely different. Absolutely, absolutely. So don't buy into the fact that they say you can't release natural growth hormone through lifting. That gives me the excuse of taking a synthetic. And we don't need to take it synthetically because we have our own and we can release it. We just got to do what it needs to be done to get it released. And I'm telling you, it's the honest truth. You can release your own natural growth hormone. It can be done. So until next time, God bless you. Talk to you soon. What you want, what you want, what you want.